Welcome to another video on Keycloak Identity and Access Management System. Today I am talking about how to run Keycloak as a Docker container in your development environment. This video is only relevant for people who are using Keycloak 17 or a higher version. I have created a separate video for Keycloak lower versions. Let's get started. Here I am covering how to run Keycloak as a Docker container in development mode. Also, I will give a brief introduction to parameters for customizing the Docker container. As prerequisites, you should have a Docker installed environment to run this container. Running Keycloak on Docker is a very simple task. Let's go to the Getting Started guide page hosted on the Keycloak website. You only need to copy this line and paste it on your terminal to run the container. Before doing that, let's understand what are the parameters we are providing here. Here you can see it is set in Keycloak admin username and password. Here you can see the Keycloak image hosted at Red Hat key registry is used for the container. Now I am going to execute this command. Copied the line, pasted it here and press enter. Now you can see the Docker container is running. If you are running this container for the first time, it will download the Docker image as well. Now I am going to access it from my web browser. The default URL is localhost 8080. I click on the administration console. Here I provide the username and password as admin. Click sign in. Now I was successfully redirected to the admin console. This implies the Docker container is running without any problem. Let's go back to the Getting Started page. With this command, Keycloak is running with many default configurations. Perhaps you might need to change the default behavior. As an example, you might need to connect Keycloak with a relational database like MySQL or Postgres. In order to do these changes, you need to provide more environment variables to the Keycloak run command. By visiting this link, you can see many of the available commands. By using them, you can customize the Docker image as you require. With this, we came to the end of this video. If you have any question, please put them in the comment section. Thank you very much. See you in the next video.